Hi everyone, welcome back to Risa Does Makeup. Today I'm going to be sharing with you 5 tips to help you choose the perfect everyday lip color. As someone who has worked in the beauty industry at the retail level for more than 20 years, I have encountered a lot of women who are looking for just that one go-to perfect lipstick that's flattering and of course needs to be the right formula, hydrating and all that. So I'm not gonna go into different formulas today. This is more about just choosing the right colors. Now, working at different counters over the years, it was baffling to me as a true makeup junkie and as a makeup artist that some women only wanted one lipstick. I just couldn't fathom that as someone who owns 40, 50, 60, could be more, haven't really counted. I own so many lipsticks and I don't think I've ever finished one, to be quite honest with you. And I very rarely wear the same lip color 2 days in a row. So I realize that most women are not like that, that most do only wanna have one or two go-to lipsticks, that maybe perhaps one is for day and one is for evening. Not everybody wants a whole lipstick wardrobe. So let's get to the tips to help you the next time you go to a makeup counter looking for your perfect lipstick shade. Now the first one might seem obvious. It is to know your undertone. Are you warm? Are you cool? Are you neutral? And one of the easiest ways that I find to do that, the most reliable ways that I've noticed through the years, is to use jewelry. Some people will use, you know, the veins in your arm and tell you that if your veins are more blue, you're this, and if they're more green, they're that. For me, jewelry has always worked best. So what I recommend is taking a pair of gold earrings. And if you don't have any gold earrings at home, do this the next time you're at any major department store where you can just go up to a pair of gold earrings and hold them up to. You can just grab a pair of gold earrings and put them up to your ears in the mirror and then grab a pair of silver and put those up. So these are my gold hoops and I love my gold hoops, but I also love my silver hoops. Now, if you're thinking both of those looked pretty good on you, that's because I am a neutral. I have just as many warm tones as cool tones. My face might look very pink when I remove my makeup, but that's just from touching. But once it settles down, my skin is just very neutral. I do, even though I'm sort of fair, I do have a lot of gold running through my skin, so I am a neutral. But for a lot of women, if you were to put up these gold earrings, and honestly, the bigger the better. I probably should have grabbed some wider hoops or some bolder earrings. But if you put up gold to your skin and you feel like, ooh, that just doesn't look right, then you put up some silver and you feel like, oh, that's definitely more flattering. Then you're a cool. And if the gold looks better, then you're a warm. If both look good, you are a neutral. Now, tip number 2 might not be for everyone, but I feel like it's important to put it in here. Years ago, when I was working for Bobbi Brown, and this is many, many years ago, I was in a training with her, and she was telling us, as well as when I would see her at events, telling clients. So what Bobbi would recommend was that you would shop for your perfect lipstick shade with little to no other makeup on. Now, that's where it gets tricky for some of us, because a lot of women don't want to go out of the house, let alone shopping for makeup, go to a makeup department or a Sephora without a stitch of makeup on. So if you can, at least go with minimal makeup on. And what Bobbi would say is that if a woman goes to a makeup counter and chooses a couple lipsticks to try, when she puts on one with minimal makeup, if she has no other makeup or minimal makeup on, that really just brightens her face. And she doesn't really need anything to balance it, because your everyday go-to lipstick shouldn't be one that you need to have a smoky eye with, or you need to have a lot of bronzer and blush on to make it work. It should be a lipstick that you put that on and you automatically feel polished and pretty, and you can go out and face the world maybe with just a little bit of mascara and a brow. So that's what she would suggest. And that tip really resonated with me then and still does now, because in a world of Instagram and YouTube where people are just piling on the makeup, it's nice to kind of take it back, take a look at your skin, put on just a couple products, and just feel polished and pretty. So if you go to a counter and say the sales associate hands you a few lipsticks to try, there should be one in the bunch that, again, if you have minimal makeup on, that you put on and you just feel like, wow, this is flattering to my skin tone. So definitely keep that in mind if you can. Try to go shopping with little to no makeup on when looking for a lipstick. My third tip definitely comes from the perspective of a former beauty advisor. And if you are a beauty advisor, like at Macy's or Sephora, you know what I'm talking about. My tip is do not try on more than 3 to 5 lipsticks at a time. I have had women come to the makeup counter I was working at, or even my store when I had it, and they would try on 10, 15, 20 lipsticks, and then walk out with nothing. Because there is a point where your brain gets confused and your lips have totally changed color. They don't feel the same. You get discouraged. It's a whole psychological thing that goes on. And it's kind of like when you're smelling a lot of perfumes, they give you the beans to neutralize. It's hard to neutralize your lips. Even if you put concealer on it after you've tried several, there's still, you know, the blood has rushed to them. So the bottom line is I suggest trying to choose, narrow it down to 3 to 5. 5 is okay, 3 is better. I used to work with a girl at a makeup store that would only show people 3 lipsticks. That was it. She would cut them off. I could never do that. I'm actually not sure how she never got in trouble for that, because usually if the customer wants to keep going, you should keep going. But she would refuse. She would walk away. Because, you know, it does get frustrating. It gets frustrating for the customer. It gets frustrating for the sales associate, because there is a certain point, like I said, that everything just gets jumbled in your head and you're probably gonna not be happy. So if you can narrow the choices down. So if you are a warm tone, don't be looking at blue-based pinks or blue-based reds. And if you are someone who is very fair with light eyes and light lashes, don't be looking at like the really pale, pale lipsticks like MAC Myth, because that's going to need a lip liner and some blush and all that. That's not going to be your everyday shade. So that's my tip number 3. You will be a lot happier. The person you're working with will be a lot happier. I mean, and some sales associates are great. They won't mind. Just, you know, keep trying and keep trying. But I promise you, if you can narrow it down and not try on 10, 15, 20 lipsticks when you go to a makeup counter, you will be better off and more likely to find your perfect shade. Now, my fourth tip is to step out of your comfort zone. I've said in some of my own videos when I've done lip swatches that it's not in my comfort zone. And what that means is that it's not what I'm used to wearing. It's not what I feel the prettiest in. But I have to tell you, there's been times where I have stepped out of that zone, and I've been very glad that I did. Especially as I've gotten older, I found doing that to be much more effective and helpful in finding colors that are actually really flattering. I used to always steer away from anything but a nude, pretty much. And then as I got older and I started to lose more natural color in my face, I would have to go a little bit deeper. So I never tried a rose color, because to me, rose, like, that's grandma. That's not, you know, that's not for a young person. I mean, even at 44, I still consider myself a young person. I just thought, nah, I don't know if rose is for me. But then I would try on a rose shade and it would actually look really flattering. Or I try a bright shade. And that's one of the positives, the upsides to Instagram and to Snapchat and all those new ways to show people products that weren't around when I started in the industry. Because you can see products on different skin tones and you can say, oh, you know what, that actually looks really flattering on her. And I have a similar skin tone, so maybe I will try that. And I've had a lot of people comment to me on my Instagram if I've worn a brighter lip and say, oh, that looks great on you. I think I'm gonna try that. Now, of course, bright or nude or those might not be your everyday shade, but even so, if your everyday shade is like a soft nude, maybe you need to go to a little bit deeper nude. And I'm gonna show you some colors at the end that I think are really flattering for a lot of skin tones, so stay tuned for that. But let's finish off with the fifth tip. So tip number five is, when in doubt, go with a tinted balm. There are so many out there on the market now that are amazing. They are balms with a hint of tint that adjust to your natural lip color. I know a lot of people like the one by It Cosmetics. I think it's called Je ne sais quoi. And this one is my personal favorite. It's from Trish McEvoy, and it is the Lip Perfector Conditioning Balm. I actually have it on now. I'll put a little bit more on. And it really does transform into my perfect everyday color. Now you might think, well, I'm not gonna just wear a tinted balm to a black tie event. Actually could. You could put a little bit of a shimmery eyeshadow in the center, like a gold eyeshadow, to give it a little bit of a sparkle. You can add a liner. You can do like a Charlotte Tilbury pillow talk, or if you have a deeper skin tone, you could use Hover from MAC, or what's another, like Chestnut. Some of those lip liners that will just add even just a little bit more polish. But for every day, a no-brainer would be something like this. And as I said, it adjusts to your skin tone. And why not have really hydrated, conditioned lips at the same time? Before I conclude this video, I do want to show you, because I know you guys are going to ask, what some of my personal favorite go-to lipsticks are. And these are some that I have had for years that are just staples in my collection. One is Brave from MAC. And I know people who've been following along with my channel are thinking right now, MAC is not cruelty-free. I thought you were going cruelty-free. But I want to show you, you know, it's only been in the recent months that I've decided to go cruelty-free. And these lipsticks I've had for a long time, and not everybody watching is cruelty-free. So anyway, I just thought I would show you. I want to be truthful and show you what I have been using for years. And so this is Brave. And this is Faux. Faux is probably my all-time favorite. From Charlotte Tilbury, one of my go-tos is Penelope Pink. I love this one. And I do also own Nude Kate, and I used to have Kim KW, but those are both very light nude lipsticks, and that's the type of color that I need that other makeup on to have it be flattering on my skin. I need the liner, and I need the blush, and I need the smoky eye to make those shades work. And so what I'm talking about today is more of a color that you can just put on. It brightens up your skin tone. It's pretty. It's flattering. It is a no-brainer. Now, another favorite of mine, if I do want something a little bit brighter, but it is kind of more of a summery shade, and here we are going into fall and winter, but I wanted to show it to you anyway. It's Kidman's Kiss. Now, this would be more for somebody who is neutral to warm, because it does have a little bit of a corally, orangey undertone. So someone who's really cool might not like that. But any of these others, if you are cool toned, I think you would really enjoy them as well. So those are my tips. I hope you'll find them helpful and keep them in your mind the next time you go to the makeup counter or thinking about picking up a new everyday lip color for the fall season maybe. So thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I would love it if you would follow me on my other social media. I have Twitter, I have Instagram, I have Snapchat, I have Facebook. Everything is Risa Does Makeup. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.